Here comes the heat wave out west. And I'm gonna bring the heat in this video also. I'm not gonna rehearse anything because my fingers are too sore. That's okay, sometimes you need to take a little bit of time off. However, we're not taking time off in going full blast forward and in a great jubilant mood of a graduate. I realized several weeks ago as I was driving down the road, I realized perception is a choice. What we choose to perceive is just a choice. We're projecting definition outwards upon everything. It's not really there at all, and we're just choosing to do it. So I saw that, and I said, that's it. Having seen that, I know I'm going to graduate. Furthermore, the parameters of being a graduate have to do with seeing the two options clearly, seeing the two options, so you can make a meaningful choice. And I see the mind's training program, the program of trying to kill itself, and the program of letting go of the spirit trying to kill itself, letting go of definitions. Keep in mind that what this existence really is redefinition, because you cannot redefine something until there's at first a definition. The first has to be a definition, and then the redefinition happens. The redefinition is what we view as death. It's a training program, so spirit can it believes it can die to what it is, and then be reborn as to something new, a prime creator instead of spirit, instead of the Son of God being prime creator now. So I realized I'm going to graduate because I can see the two training programs now. I can say, okay, I can choose this one or that one. And it's a meaningful choice because I'm seeing it clearly, what the programs are really about. And so I'm preparing for that. I'm in the mood for that now. I'm dropping concern. All this concern about the future of this world, I say, it doesn't, it's not a concern for me. It's not a concern for me. And the way to help others is to showcase the Holy Spirit's training program. It shows, look, there is another training program and it works. That's the only way to help people. It's the only way. The mind keeps telling us there's all these other ways to help, and I've been looking at the world, no way, it doesn't help. It doesn't help. We just keep shuffling definitions to make it seem like it's helping. It's not helping. The only ones that really help are those who have taken the Holy Spirit's training program. Drop definitions of life, because life is completely transcendent of any definition. And then come to this world and showcase that and show, look, this is your heritage. This is your heritage. This is what you really are. You're beyond definition, and there's a training program to help you drop definitions. That's what really helps. That's what really helps. The rest of the stuff, forget it. It's a waste of time. So having seen those teachers who truly help, I said, yeah, that this is it. Let's work towards that. Let's see if we can get things clear so a meaningful choice can be taken. A meaningful choice. Without a meaningful choice, we will vacillate and it'll just become all confused and chaotic and suffer terrible mental problems unless we see each choice exactly as it is. See it as it is. So see the world as it is, a training program to try and teach spirit how to kill itself, how to die to what it is. Now, of course, in reality, there's no death, there are no secrets, there's nothing hidden. Everything is shared with everything. So when spirit said to mind, I want to become prime creator. I want to be prime creator. Mind says, yes, boss. And then immediately starts lying. Okay, he says, boss, I have something to tell you. I never wanted to tell you this before because it wasn't time. But now that you've asked to be prime creator, I can finally tell you. I've had a secret all along, and there's something I need to tell you. And spirit says, secret? What's a secret? Time says, and mind says, well, you'll understand it. What's gradually? What's understand? You know, spirit says, I don't get this. And mind says, just be patient. What's patience? Well, we'll get to all of this soon. And what's soon? You know, and so spirit's like, ask all these questions of mind. And mind says, well, listen to me. Just trust me. I know what I'm doing. And here's the story that mind tells spirit, that God has a secret. And God has kept this secret hidden from spirit all from the very beginning, a deep, dark, hidden secret. And what is that secret? Secret of death. That's what God's kept hidden. And mind tells spirit, spirit, if you just die, in dying, you will release a secret power and you will be resurrected as the new prime creator. You see, the reason why God has been hiding this from you is God doesn't want you to become greater than God, you see. But there is a way, but God's been hiding it. Very, very secret. It's the deepest, deepest secret. But I know the secret, and I'm going to show you where God has been hiding this secret all along. And Spirit says, wow, wow, that's amazing. I mean, I never knew anything about this at all. Mind, you're incredible, Mind. Thank you for telling me all this stuff. And so now Mind says, okay, we're going to go on this long, long journey, and it's going to be an incredible adventure, the greatest adventure there is in reality. Nothing can even touch this. It's so great, because at the end of this journey, you're going to be able to die and become prime creator. So let's go on this journey. And Spirit says, wow, this sounds like the greatest adventure ever. I'm really up for this. And so Spirit jumps into this simulation of time and this training program that Mind is presenting. Mind says, I got this great adventure, but it's really a training program. And so Spirit is watching this, everything that Mind is doing. Mind says, you just pay attention to this and believe in it. And your belief in it is going to be the adventure. If you can just maintain your belief in this through thick and thin, you will get to the end, you'll persevere, and you will find the secret of death that God has been hiding from you. So Spirit is like trying really hard to believe. Yeah, I believe. Yeah, I believe. I'll do everything to believe. I gotta believe. I gotta believe in this. And keeps believing, keeps being spellbound. I'm totally spellbound to this, all this impermanence, this training program. And Mind says, that's great. You're doing great. You're doing great. You're almost there. You're really doing great. Great progress. Spirit says, huh, progress? What's that? And deep down, Spirit says, I don't really understand anything that Mind is telling me about progress and learning and time and secrets and hiding and death. And what? I have no idea what any of this stuff is, really. No idea. I feel like I might fail at this because I just don't really believe it. But I gotta try it. I don't even know what trying is, but I'm just very confused deep down, very confused about this whole thing. Because, of course, there's none of that stuff in reality. It's all just completely made up. Mind has just invented all this stuff out of thin air. And it's just and it's telling Spirit that this is the journey, this is the adventure. It's an adventure. So Spirit understands adventure. So Spirit say, oh, it's all an adventure. Okay, yeah, if you put it that way, I kind of go along with it. If it's just an incredible adventure, I love adventure. So Spirit thinks this whole thing is an incredible adventure. But in truth, the Holy Spirit will tell you it's nothing at all. There is no secret. There's nothing hidden. There is no death. There is no journey to find death. There is no adventure to find it. There's nothing at all. We're all just going around, going nowhere, wandering aimlessly, meaninglessly, nowhere. Nothing's happening at all. And Mind says, look, don't look there. Don't look there, because if you look there, God is going to grab you and annihilate you, because he knows now that there is this, that we know the secret of dying and resurrection and becoming the new prime creator. And he's trying to stop us desperately. And if you look there, he'll see you and he'll grab you and he'll annihilate you so you can never replace him as prime creator. You see, he's a very jealous God. And so we say, wow, really, Mind? That's scary. I don't know. You know, so this is what's taking place. And Mind keeps scaring us into not looking where we need to look. And we just need to look and see God. Go, God's not angry. God's not jealous. God doesn't have any secrets. There's no such thing as death. There's no such thing as a time and learning and trust and all these belief. Oh, that's totally bogus. There's nothing to it at all. Just lies the Mind has been presenting. That's what the Mind doesn't want us to see. So we avoid that at all costs. At all costs. So this is the simple preparation. Now, The Holy Spirit's training program takes place in a realm. A realm is different than a planet. I call it the fifth dimensional realm, as it were, because it doesn't have borders. It doesn't have strict definitions. Where does it end? There isn't any ending to it. You never come to an ending of it. When you wander in that realm, it goes on indefinitely. You never come to a boundaries, an end to it. So it's a realm. Whereas this planet, you can just see, you know, it comes to an end, as it were. It's finite. It's a globe. We now realize from space, we just live on this little marble. You know, it's not indefinite at all. So the Holy Spirit's training program is in a realm, a death-free realm, where all forms are stable, set definition. Okay, stable, stability, stable definition. There's no redefinition taking place. Again, keep in mind that definition is only there in this, the ego's, the game of trying to die to what we are, simulation of that. Its definition exists in order to be redefined. So the first step, the letting go, the big step we take is to perceive definitions, in other words, things that are not being redefined. They're not dying. So definitions are still there, we're still perceiving, and yet they're not being redefined. In other words, that tree in the death-free realms, you see a tree, and you know for a fact, you can tell, that tree has always been here. From the very beginning of this realm, that tree has been there, and will always be there. It will always be there. It's not being redefined. Okay. Heat wave. So everything there is not being redefined. So that's where you start. And you say, hey, this is different. I don't get a sense of any death. I don't get a sense of needing to learn something, to have faith, to believe, to learn. This is something different. I feel like the sense of belonging here. Like I belong, that this somehow kicks up an ancient memory of belonging. Of oneness, of home. And then that's where you start then easing back towards being comfortable without any definitions at all. Eventually, by dwelling in the death-free realm, you no longer need definitions. Eventually, you simply feel like, my sense of reality is now expands beyond all definitions. I have no need for them at all. Far cry from this world here and all the nonsense that has gone on and continues to go on here of constant redefinition. The redefinition mill is being cranked up now to an extraordinary extent. Now, if anyone thought that, my future exists in this world, then they're going to be very unhappy. Unless they're fools, and there are many fools here. Those who have just recently dived into this simulation, this training program of mine, they're still full of belief. They're saying, I believe in this. Okay, because that's all they got. I believe in this adventure. This is a great adventure, they say. I really believe this is going to be a great adventure. And those who have been on this quote-unquote great adventure for a long time, they know, they gradually realize this is completely bogus. This is a lie. It's all a lie. So they're not taken in by the lies, but the neophytes still are full of vim and vigor and belief in this adventure, that this adventure is just going to be a killer adventure, you know. Yeah, so they're really into it. Like, wow, we're going to learn how to die. This is incredible. So there is a very big difference in the world between those who are wise and those who are unwise. It is the difference between the wheat and the tares, okay. The sheep and the goats. It's a huge, huge difference. There are a lot of goats in this world right now. They're ruling the roost. Yeah, and they have everything to themselves now. They say, we're in charge. Here comes the change. And we believe in this adventure. This is, you know. So they're in charge of the world right now. as I say, the inmates are in charge of the asylum. But that doesn't mean that the wise are at the mercy of the foolish, the naive, the neophytes. They're not. They're not. They're not. This is graduation time. Okay, that means that we get a big boost also at this time towards the non-redefined realms, the death-free realms, where nothing is being redefined. It doesn't mean there's nothing there. It's just there's nothing's being redefined. That all the plants and the landscape is there, beautiful place, but none of it's being redefined. You see some flowers, and those flowers have always been there. And that strikes you differently than anything in this world can possibly strike you. It really does. It's just, I've experienced it. It is. You cannot put it in words that we're used to. It touches somewhere, you know, deep in your memory of who you are, to see that this flower, the flowers there, so beautiful, they've always been there. They've never been redefined. There's nothing redefining them at all. But how can we have that experience in this world? We cannot. We cannot. The closest we get to is like a diamond. But where is the diamond? It's in the world. Everything in the world is being redefined. And even a diamond is gradually. So it doesn't work at all. It doesn't work. It's not the same. Because everything in the death-free realm is free of redefinition. Has always been there. Everything has always been there. And it's just too precious, you know. It's too precious for words. It's beyond anything that we can fake in this world. The mind keeps trying to fake it, like, oh, here's the diamonds, here's the jewelry. Look how timeless you are. Look how permanent you are, and all this nonsense. Well, the hand that's wearing the diamond ring is wrinkling with age spots, and it's gonna turn into a skeleton pretty soon, you know. So where is the true impact of that? It's not there. So this is graduation time. Obviously, the world, the neophytes have now have plotted their course forward, and so we can say, okay, we knew that was coming. The wise knew it was coming. We were warned ahead of time. We were warned that at some point the world would be taken over by the neophytes, who have this, you know, naive belief in the adventure that they're going to succeed. So we were warned about that. We said, you have to prepare to ascend into the death-free realms at this point. You have to prepare for it. You have to graduate. It's time to graduate. So you better really hit the books. You better really study. Really, really, really study. I certainly have done that. It's like a student who every single day studies like mad, like for a final. It was at the final exam were tomorrow. That's how I've studied my entire life, like that. Like the final exam was tomorrow. I had to have the answer tonight before, you know, otherwise I'm going to flunk. And that's how I've studied. So the studying is just the effort to clarify options and to see clearly what the options actually are, and to get free of all this disillusionment, you know, be disillusioned from all these illusions, all these lies of the mind, and say, ah, you know, there never was any possibility of success with this adventure. It was a misadventure. It wasn't an adventure, it was a misadventure. So we've had a totally whimsical and eccentric, madcap, farcical, horrible misadventure. So and now we're getting ready to graduate from that. If you knew that you wouldn't be part of this future that's coming, this dystopian future that is run by very naive neophytes who have literally thrown out the baby with the bathwater, who are now viewing the world through the prism of secular humanism and demonizing the prism of traditional religious values, which are actually based on the the importance of studying to ascend into the death-free realms. That's what religions are for. Into the death-free realms. That's what religion is for. Their discipline is discipline. It's difficult discipline. You know, most people don't want to study every day of their lives. They don't want to keep their nose to the grindstone. They want to, you know, jump into the cesspool of the flesh. But religion says no. You'll regret it if you do that. Don't do it because you must postpone gratification. Don't go in for instant gratification. That's the wrong way because you will miss your opportunity if you do that. You will miss your opportunity. That's exactly what religions are based on, actually. And of course, the neophytes of today don't have the slightest clue what the purpose or importance of religion is. To them, it's completely useless, has no value. You know, it's just some kind of appendix. You know, they want to get rid of as fast as possible. In fact, it's an embarrassment to them. They say, we're so embarrassed to live on a planet where they have these people that have religious values or something. Well, it's actually just the opposite. The people who have religious values are extremely embarrassed to be living on a planet with so many very naive neophytes here, you know. The inmates of an asylum, an insane asylum. Very embarrassing to be here. Almost mortifying, you know. My God, how embarrassing. It's shocking. The level of ignorance is shocking. And yet those are the people who are running the show on this planet right now. And they see nothing wrong with that whatsoever, of simply running everything through an unelected bureaucracy to mandate. And soon there'll be vows for everything. You have to vow allegiance to this. You must disavow God. You must disavow religion. You must disavow all values in order to even get bread to eat, so to speak. And it's just, there's no end to the stupidity of those in charge at this point. There is no end. When you're completely naive and a neophyte in this simulation training program, there's no end to the darkness that you go blundering into, you know, stepping off into the abyss. You just, like, you don't even know it's there. You don't even realize what you're doing. You're so foolish. So to wrest control of the planet from these higher, wiser values, which are pragmatic values. They're not absolutes, you see. These knuckleheads keep thinking, oh, these are absolutes. They think they don't see the purpose of them. They're not absolutes. They are means to an end. It's the end that's been lost sight of. Where is this trying to get us to? It's trying to get us to the ascension into the death-free realm. It's trying to get us into the Holy Spirit's training program, is what it's trying to do. And it's trying to get us salvation from this horrible spellboundness that we are in to the mind story, the mind's training program, of this adventure to find death. We think, wow, when we find death, we're going to be prime creator. So everybody's thinking, let's all help each other here. Let's all get together and work together on this great adventure we're on. And so it's, the mind makes it this, like, all-important thing that, like, you know, your spiritual evolution is dependent. You have a spiritual evolution that's dependent on being successful in this adventure. And let come on, everybody, and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It markets it very severely to everybody. And we've made to feel guilty if we don't go along. We're holding the adventure back. We're not being part of the adventure, you know. it's a misadventure is what's going on. We cannot die to what we are. There's no death in reality. We can't become prime creator. This is all nonsense, an eccentric whim. So we're at the crossroads now, we're at graduation time, because the ascension will be coming, the shift in some way that we will have the stepping stones we need. Stable state, the big boost is, how I see it, is stable state, this stable definition, stable state. We will somehow begin to feel the vibe of that stable state, whether it's in a person, or it's here, someone's here, teachers, or various teachers, inner feeling. Somehow, we will start feeling stable definition, stable state. It's very different. We no longer will feel that we're a male, we'll no longer feel that we're a female, we won't feel an age, a young, or old, or anything. We'll have a stable state. It'll be a stable state. How we feel, we'll say, well, I just feel a sense of complete stability. That's all I feel. See, all these other these thoughts, etc., are not going to be touching it. Because that stable state that we feel is how we are going to be in the Death Ray realms. Is you're around everything is a stable state. And so you automatically, your feeling of stable state grows and grows and grows and grows and grows and expands in you. But we can start out right now with this stable state. We can start out. The great gurus were in this stable state. No definition. See, nothing that happened caused their state to change. And they really, you couldn't feel any sense of gender in them at all. Or any sense of any definition, really. Or any redefinition, and no redefinition taking place there. It's just a stable state. Great examples, Raman Maharshi and Nand Maima, two great examples of that. Total stable stateness. That's all there was. There's a stable stateness. And so that is super, super helpful for us. And we can go into that stable state as well. Absolutely. And we will. We will. That is our first step. That is the stepping stone, as it were, is to start getting used to this. See, in the death-free realms, everything is that way. Whereas in this world, you can come across a guru or a sage, a saint, a savior who's in that steady state. In that steady state. And then you can start to feel, this is how the steady state feels, okay. And that gets you ready for the death-free realms, where everything is that way. Everything. Ananda Maima said, like it or not, every one of you has to eventually go to the death-free realms. Every one of you. So, she was just helping get us ready for that by being here in stable state. I mean, she, just as a pronoun of the gender of her body, but there was no she there at all. It was just a stable state was there, completely stable state. Call it whatever you want, nirvikalpa samadhi, open-eyed samadhi, whatever, it's stable state. Nirvana, not moving, stable state was there. It's just that she was not redefining. There's no redefining taking place, just like in the death-free realm, the tree. That tree has always been that tree. It's always been there. There's been no redefining taking place. So remember, the way to get to heal the continuity problem is stable state, stable definition. No redefining taking place. And getting used to that, and then we drop definition. So we don't drop definition right now. First, we experience stable stateness, stable stateness. No redefinitions taking place. That's the intermediate step. So all we're aiming for is the intermediate step. That's it. Once we take the intermediate step, the final step is automatically going to be there. We will go beyond all need of any definition at all. Okay, so the gurus are just getting us ready for the death-free realm, is what they're doing. So, will the guru show up? We'll find out. Or how will they show up is the question. Not will they, but definitely. How will it happen? How will all of this stable stateness begin to be felt? I don't have any answer for that yet. But it won't be long. It won't be long until we find out. That is for sure. The important thing is for us to prepare for that. Is to prepare for that, not to try and figure out, you know, ahead of time exactly the details of it, but rather to continue to work towards that so that we're prepared for that. We understand the utility of it. So really, when such a guru is here, you go to see them, you're not going to ask questions. They're already in the stable state. You know what it's for. So you just go there and you just sit there. And you just experience it. and you get used to it. And you say, ah, I like this, I'm getting used to it. That's it. Now, those who come and ask questions of the guru to appear normal to everybody, smiles and answers questions, but you'll see a bunch of people just sitting there quietly. They're not the slightest bit interested in what the guru is saying at all. Not even, it's the stable state that they're experiencing. They're experiencing this incredible stable state, free of redefinition. And they know that by getting used to this, that they are preparing themselves to actually ascend into the death-free realms. That's what they know. So we know that here. We already know that here because it's being given out. I'm giving this information out, sharing this information with everybody. So we can know. There's no excuses. So we're not saying, hey, can you go to my country and talk to my people and smile and have a conversation? No, because that's not where it's at. The real gurus are not here to give a talk at all. They're not here to give a talk. I'll do the talking because I'm not a real guru. But the real gurus have speakers that will talk like this. But they're not here to talk. They're more like they're here to sit. They're here to sit. They can talk, of course, but that's not why they're here. They're not here to give speeches. They're not here to write books. They're not here to write books. The real gurus are not here to write books. I mean, how much did Brahmana write? Almost nothing. Almost nothing. Ananda Maima wrote nothing. She couldn't really write. Couldn't read. Couldn't write. Had no, zero interest in any of that stuff. No interest in giving speeches. Nothing. Just sitting. Just quietly sitting. And letting people experience this freedom from redefinition, this stable definition. And of course, she was beyond the stable definition too. She was also in the state of beyond all definition, but was able to present a body, a definition here, a stable field of definition in the world. So that's a great grace to the world, actually. Was not here to influence society, or influence politics, or do charity work, or do anything at all, except to grace those graduates with this stable definition state. There's a work of grace for those who are ready to graduate. Those who are ready to graduate, they deserve the grace, you see. We deserve it. You have to feel we deserve it. We absolutely deserve it. We're super deserving of it right now. Who could be more deserving of it? Having battled through these times of the 20th century and the first 13 years of this next century, who could deserve it more? I mean, it's just been the most incredibly difficult time. So they're not here for any legacy. They're not here in these particular times. They're here for graduation. They're like, you know, at graduation, the dean shows up, the school superintendent shows up, the mayor shows up, and if it's a big graduation, the governor will show up or whatever. The dignitaries show up at graduation to acknowledge the graduates and say, you know, we're here to acknowledge your great job that you did. So at this time, where this is the end of the cycle, 4D has taken over, the knuckleheads have taken over here. It's time for the graduation. So that means the dignitaries will show up. For sure they'll show up. And of course we might be flummoxed by that. I don't know if I will be flummoxed or not. I really don't know. It's interesting that somehow I end up meeting dignitaries various places without even trying. So I'm kind of used to like meeting, you know, I've met some very famous people and spiritual dignitaries like Dalai Lama, and then Dafri John, Adya Shanti, various mayors, and various artists and things that just it just happens without my trying to, really. And so perhaps that's preparing for these true dignitaries to show up. At least you have a sense of that. Been around like very rich people, very privileged people, very entitled people. So when the dignitaries show up for the graduation ceremonies, hopefully, you know, we'll all be able to accept it. Not panic is the whole thing. Panicking is the whole thing. To not panic. Well, I mean, what if the actual Jesus showed up? The actual Jesus. I mean, you know, most people, Christians, would panic because they say, well, I'm not quite clear. You know, I'm not really sure what to do. I don't know how to deal with this. Not yet. I'm not ready yet. So I've spent. It's been 108, 35 years of studying A Course in Miracles now at this point. 56 years of constantly considering Christianity and teachings of Jesus and trying to see what is really true. What is it? What is the part of what is true about them? And where has the mind come in and distorted everything? So I've listened to the Holy Spirit, so I feel like I can at least, if an effort needs to be made, I can make an effort to get on the same page, or try to get on the same page, or close. And should be able to simply, you know, from a standpoint of a work ethic. So there's no reason to panic, really. I don't see any reason to panic. I'm used to handling changes of perspective, and if things are different, okay, if I need to change my golf swing, I'll change my golf swing. Yeah, it's not a problem. It's like that. I just did that. Completely changed my golf swing. Just in a matter of a minute. And I see, this works great. This will work great. Okay, it's not a problem. There's no lessons or anything. So, we'll see. I don't know. But the dignitaries will show up. And how we relate to that, I don't know. But I would say we'll probably be fine. My sense is I'll be fine. I'm not even worried about it. Looking forward to it. And because, again, the purpose is to stable state. Here's the stable state. Here's a stable state. Here's a practice for you. Just practice. And just showing up saying, okay, it's time to now start practicing this. It's okay, let's start practicing it. Say, all right, let's do it. Start practicing feeling this stable state. I'm not this, I'm not that, I'm not changing this, all of this fluidity of change and no, it's stable, there's a stability. I don't feel I'm a person or a non-person. Again, male, female, I don't feel I belong to this generation or that generation. I don't feel I'm young or old or middle-aged. I don't feel I'm wealthy or poor. Or I just don't feel any of that stratification. And I don't feel like I'm changing what I am is changing this way or that way. No, none of that's happening. I feel very stable. So it's just this feeling of great, great stability. That is what we're looking forward to. Okay, so that's I'm defining that. And pointing this out is that's what we're going towards, is this very, get familiar with this very stable state. So we're not really coming to ask questions. Give me your theology. Can you explain your cosmology? We're not going there for that. We're not asking them that. That's not the purpose at all. There's one purpose. Let's just get familiar with this stable feeling of a stable state. Imagine if the Buddha was here and he's sitting there in his asana, his perfect posture and meditation, and he's in this completely stable condition. And he just, you know, you just come there and you sit and you just start to feel it. You just start to pick it up. It's like contact high of the stable state. Don't need to say anything. Now I assume this is the deeper purpose behind the Hindu use of idols, of gods and goddesses, etc., is to people to practice the stability. Here is something representing a stable state. And you go and you sit there and you meditate on that, realizing that's what it's for, is to feel this stable state. I would assume that's the true purpose of it. That's not what most people use it for. They're going there to pray for health boons in their life. Can you change my life some way? Can you make my life better? That's not the real purpose of those idols, etc. Again, we're almost there. Today's the 27th, and already the knuckleheads have made it clear. It's now, you know, we now know the writing is on the wall. We know that there is this massive redefinition taking place, and there's no stopping it. There is no stopping it at all, and we don't have to bang our heads against a wall complaining about it. We knew this was coming. So we have prepared to step beyond it. So instead of being down, don't anyone be downcast at this time. In fact, celebrate, because this is when the dignitaries will show up. All right? When the dignitaries will show up for our graduation ceremonies. The ones who have done the work graduate. Like just like in high school or something, you do the work, you get your diploma. If you flunk all the classes, you don't. So those who have passed the classes, and they are going to get their diploma, and the dignitaries will show up. So we don't have to be freaking out about what's happening in the world at all. Every time something happens, I say, it's too late. You know, whatever happens in the world, whatever bad happens in the world that you see right now, you just smile and laugh and say, it's too late. Sorry, it's too late. I'm getting my diploma. You see, I'm getting my diploma. I'm graduating. It's too late. I don't have to worry about all the petty stuff that goes on in high school anymore. All those terrible, you know, angst and struggles and petty stuff that's constantly going on in high school. Forget it. I'm out of here. School's out. No more classes in high school. I'm finished with this place. I'm nothing but happy. So just laugh and say, too late. Too late. It's too late. You're too late. Dollar. Day late and a dollar short for all this stuff. Problems are too late for, too late now. And so have that, you know, laugh about it. Be happy about it. That this stuff is too late now. It's all too late. you outran it. You outran it, and it's like you're up on the high spot now, and all these problems are down below, and you're saying, you missed me. It's too late. I escaped. So that's the feeling. Have that feeling. Just keep on having that feeling. Like it's too late. I'm graduating. I get it. I understand. I get it. I can accept it. Stable state. Work on first definitions that are not being redefined, and then eventually you will go beyond definitions. It's all very simple. It's not difficult. There's nothing mystical, tricky about it. Nothing's hidden. There are no secrets. And you know, this misadventure we've been on is just chasing after something which doesn't exist, which is death. Death of spirit doesn't exist. So it's all been a misadventure. The mind, we told the mind to lie to us, and that's all it's been doing is lying to us. It's just nothing but a pack of lies. And that's okay, because we told the mind to lie to us. But now we're telling the mind to tell us the truth and give us a training program to help us go beyond definition altogether. Simple stuff. Not difficult. If we just look in the right place, we see it. So we're getting ready for the graduation, and there you go. That's it for this one.